In the race to scale the Ethereum blockchain, two factions have emerged as dominant players in the layer 2 space: optimistic rollups and zero knowledge rollups, or ZK rollups in short. So let's explain the differences and get started. So let's get started with optimistic rollups. Optimistic rollups take computation and state storage off-chain. While the execution of transactions occurs on the rollup outside of Ethereum, transaction data is passed down and stored on Ethereum's mainnet. This is done by bundling transactions together into one large transaction, which is passed on Ethereum as call data. This method also allows gas fees on Ethereum to be spread across all of the transactions included in the bundled transaction, which is why gas fees on optimistic rollups tend to be much lower than on the Ethereum mainnet. So optimistic rollups assume that all transactions computed off-chain are valid and accurate when posting them to Ethereum without submitting a proof of validity, hence the term optimistic. As such, to combat fraudulent transactions, a challenge period is put in place in which anyone can challenge the transactions posted. If it is proven that fraudulent transactions have been included, the optimistic rollup will re-execute the valid transactions and update their state accordingly. Conversely, if the challenge period passes with no successful challenge, the transactions become finalized. So let's talk about ZK rollups. In the other corner, we have ZK rollups, which are far less optimistic. While ZK rollups also do computations off-chain, they provide a cryptographic proof to prove that the state update that they are passing to Ethereum is truly the result of all the transactions that have occurred on the ZK rollup. These validity proofs allow any party to verify the accuracy of the state update without knowing the details of the transactions leading up to it, hence the name zero knowledge. Since ZK rollups are able to provide proof of the accuracy of their transactions, there is no need for a challenge period on ZK rollups. Moreover, unlike optimistic rollups, ZK rollups need not post every transaction onto Ethereum, but rather just the proofs. However, this comes with the burden of generating the fraud proof, which tends to be highly resource consuming and often requires a high level of expertise to run. But not all ZK rollups are made equal. ZK rollups can also be further broken down into ZkSNARKs and ZkSTARKs. So let's talk about the difference between ZkSNARKs and ZkSTARKs. Both ZK-STARKs, or zero-knowledge scalable transparent argument of knowledge, and ZK-SNARKs, zero-knowledge succinct non-interactive argument of knowledge, strive to achieve the same purpose, which is to enable ZK proofs and to enable scaling of blockchain. However, they do have quite significant differences between them. ZK-SNARKs came first, being initially popularized by privacy protocol Zcash. This head start allowed ZK-SNARKs to build up a strong community of developers and tooling, which allow it to be used much more widely today. ZK-SNARKs also use a much smaller proof size, which requires less gas and time to verify. However, the downside to this was a much slower computation time to generate the proof. However, ZK-STARKs have their own benefits too. One of the major downsides to ZK-SNARKs is the need for a trusted setup in the initial phase. This also means that if the setup process was not conducted properly, the chain could be susceptible to exploits in the future from malicious parties. ZK-STARKs do not use a trusted setup, and hence they are not susceptible to such an attack. Moreover, ZK-STARKs tend to generate proofs more quickly, allowing ZK-STARKs to potentially scale better. And there is no clear winner for now between the two, and both technologies are still being implemented in a developing project. As optimistic rollups like Arbitrum and Optimism take the lead in early 2023, ZK rollups are slowly closing in on them. And more specifically, it is the ZK rollups that are Ethereum Virtual Machine or EVM compatible that the market is especially excited about. So what are ZkEVMs? So ZkEVMs refer to the ZK rollup that are fully compatible with the EVM. This means that any application currently on Ethereum or any other EVM compatible chain, such as Polygon and Avalanche, will be able to deploy onto a ZkEVM with minimal modifications to their code base. EVM compatibility has always been a highly sought after trait for a new chain as a strategy to attract developers and also users. After all, the majority of total value locked, or TVL, on chain has always been on Ethereum, and with the chain holding more than 50% of all TVL at any point. And as such, it's no surprise that alternative layer 1 or L1 chains, which are EVM compatible, proved to be attractive to existing Ethereum developers. They could deploy their project on another chain with relatively lesser effort while still reaping the rewards of having a whole new user base. Likewise, while ZK rollups such as Starknet are already live on mainnet, they've not gained significant traction, likely due to their lack of EVM compatibility and major decentralized applications or dApps on the chain. Therefore, with the wave of announcements from major ZK EVM players in the space in early 2023, many crypto users are eager to explore their options in the ZK EVM space.